Welcome to episode 43 with special guest host, my extra special friend, Nicole Nelson.
And she's not mental.
This is the Dan and Cody podcast.
A toy boat.
The arsonist had oddly shaped feet.
This is the Dan and Cody podcast.
Red leather, yellow leather.
Saddle up, partner.
So we're here. I'm here. Cody's not here. Nicole is here. Nicole Nelson from episode 14. And yeah.
Oh, welcome my God. Back. I was on episode 14.
You were on episode
43.
You were on episode 14 and it's 43.
That's
and
crazy.
If you haven't listened to episode 14, you should. We talked about being seasonally vegan.
Which is that season now.
You're back. Tis the season right now.
Tis the season for not eating animals.
Yeah. You didn't give a shit about the animals. It was all about you.
Oh, yeah. I still don't care about animals.
Right.
Yeah.
We talked about Hooch, the Hooch sketch team.
Yeah.
At Nerdist School.
Going strong. It's actually probably been a year that... Well, we've been a team for a year now.
Yeah. You guys are killing it, right?
Yeah, we're killing.
We talked about the Little Bush Girl.
No. It's called the Little Bush Deer.
Oh, Little Bush Deer.
Where I act like an animal.
What? No, you were like you're like a sweet little girl.
Yeah, no, that's an animal. It's a deer. Little bush deer. A bush deer is something.
Damn.
It's an animal.
I didn't I didn't get that at all. I thought you were just being like a little girl.
You meant like little bush deer.
Yeah,
like
that makes it even more weird.
I'm a deer.
But
I'm
remember,
a baby deer.
But remember, Cody was like, why am I turned on by that?
Oh,
so now it's even creepier.
Well,
now it's even creepier.
Yeah.
And we talked about how Jonathan Taylor Thomas shaped your life.
Yes. And his birthday was September 12th.
Wow.
Yeah, maybe.
So September's the month of Nicole.
I guess.
From
it's
now
it's
on.
When I do a lot of things.
Yeah, that's good. So what's going on? What's going on in the world?
I got a new car.
Dope. What car?
A Kia Soul 2015.
That's like my competitor car.
I know.
Because I have the Cube.
The Cube isn't made anymore, right?
Yeah, I think they stopped.
And they're also stopping the Scion. So
are
the
they?
Kia is pretty much the only Cube-like car still going.
What?
Yeah. Well,
so
the Kia,
Kia
Soul.
Wins.
Yeah, well, Kia's really, I've heard, upped their standards and...
They really have.
And honestly, I went to Kia downtown to get it. It's like the biggest car dealership for Kia in the nation.
Damn.
And there was a scratch on the door, and I was like, I'm not buying this car because it has a scratch on it.
What?
And
was
they were
used?
Like, we will fix it. I'm like, okay, when? This is before I even test drove it. It was used about, it only had 9,000 miles on it.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Damn.
And I paid cash.
You dropped cash on that?
$13,000. Can you believe I got it for $13,000?
No.
Out
what year?
The door.
What year?
2015, 9,000 miles.
And it's paid off.
I paid cash.
Paid quiche.
Yes.
Damn, that's the way to do it,
I mean,
man.
My car insurance is $300 a month, but...
Fuck.
Do
you have DUIs?
Couple of accidents. No.
Oh, accidents?
Excuse me.
Hey, I have that.
You first think that's what's on there? Everyone asks that, actually, and I never realized it was rude until now.
Well, but most people who have high insurance have DUIs.
I just have 10 accidents in the last 3 years.
Jesus.
No, I'm just kidding. Dan, that's ridiculous. No, I have three. And a speeding ticket. So apparently that's not good for everybody. One insurance company told me, I'm sorry, we can't take you whatsoever.
What?
We can't even offer you a rate, quote.
Are you kidding? Did you do Progressive?
Yes, I went with Progressive and I called every single insurance company and they were giving me some pretty crazy, one was up to $450 a month and I'm like, you gotta be kidding me.
Dude, that is straight up
I cannot do that. That's half of my rent.
Yeah, that's like three DUI territory, $400.
And that's like,
that's a lot.
If I had a car payment and car insurance, it's like pointless that I even paid the car, you know, paid cash for the car, but...
And you're over 25. Like, rates go down over 25.
But also, the insurance went up because it is a newer car. So,
Right.
But I love it. I really do. Because I'm a Jeep person. And it was really hard for me to not go with Jeep. It took someone to convince me. And I was just like, oh, Bluetooth accessible? I'm sold. Because the Jeep has no features whatsoever. Like,
well, that's
at all.
The thing.
Lucky to have power windows on a Jeep.
It's like
any type of Jeep.
Anything. I feel like anything pre-2010 is like featureless now. And like all the cars now have all this crazy shit.
Well, it's funny because my car now that's newer, it doesn't have a CD player.
It just doesn't even have one.
But who gives a shit?
Yeah, no one's...
It's got the Bluetooth hook.
And the auxiliary plug?
The first day I got it, that day when I picked it up, I drove to Vegas.
That
same
day.
For my birthday. And I told my brother, because I was meeting him up there, I was like, I could have drove all the way across the country.
Yeah.
This was... It was great. I was in a new car. I had all these... It's a great car. It's fun. It's still a stick.
Whoa, you got a stick.
I know, and that's why I think I got it for a cheaper price.
Wow.
Because even the guys that fixed the scratch couldn't drive my car into the body shop.
Especially that kind of... It's like... That's like mid sports utility, you know? You don't see those made with
sticks. I don't think valets nowadays know how to drive stick.
That's a shame.
Because they don't really make them anymore.
I'm proud of you. But a lot of women don't know
how to
drive stick.
Honestly, Dan, I almost said, is it worth it sitting in traffic in Hollywood?
Ding, ding, ding.
And then I said, you're damn right it is.
For $5,000
less?
And
I still love it.
I still do. But do you think driving
stick... It makes me
stick...
feel like a man.
Do you think that driving the stick has led to those three accidents? Were they your fault?
Excuse me. I think it had to do with me being a crazy maniac. Mm. I scare everybody that gets in the car.
You're a crazy
Uber
person.
And Lyft won't take me.
Oh, you tried to get Uber? You tried to be one?
Yeah.
And they were like, fuck no.
Because I have a new car. They were like, no, you have a terrible history.
Damn. Well, it's kind of a gift and a curse. Uber has, like, fucked my car up.
Oh, are you still doing it?
Every now and then.
Yeah.
Got to get that extra money.
It's fucked your car up like what?
Just like, I have like 97,000 miles on it now.
Oh.
I have so many miles on it.
Oh, yeah. You're right. It probably isn't worth it for me to do that.
Yeah. You like, run it into the ground.
Yeah.
And, yeah, the people suck. Like, I'll go out and I'll be like, I'm going to do this for like 5 hours tonight. And make so much money, and then you get, like, one dickhead, and you're like, fuck this, I'm going home. I'm better than this. I don't need to do this. Fuck it.
Yeah.
The things we do for money.
Well, yeah. I went to the dentist for the first time in probably 7 years.
Oh, isn't that the worst? That's the worst.
I only had 4 cavities, and I got them all filled.
In one day?
Yep.
You just were like, I want it all.
I did it.
Oh.
And, I'm proud of myself for doing that, because I don't like needles and I don't like going to the doctors. I also got a physical.
Oh.
My first physical in 5 years.
Nice.
Mm-hmm.
Haven't gotten
the results back yet, but here's hoping.
Well, we're fingers crossed here at the Dan and Cody podcast.
I could die right here. Who knows? They call a day late. They're like, you have... Okay, she just died.
We have paramedics on standby.
Do you?
Mm-hmm. They're here.
Okay.
Don't
They're
look
just
for them,
hiding.
Though.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, don't look for them. But they are here.
I got a physical. They haven't said anything.
Have you had cavities before?
Yeah, a long time ago when I was a kid.
Yeah. Some teeth are just prone to cavities. I've heard
that. I actually am proud that I only had 4 cavities after that long.
Yeah, that's a long
time.
Seriously,
like, I don't know. Well, now I'm trying to get my fang tooth removed.
What?
Yeah.
You have a fang
it's
tooth?
It's going to be a very hard surgery, so the dentist said.
They have to say that.
Oh, do they?
I think so.
No, I don't.
Because
acted like it could be like a life or death thing. And I was like, you know what? Take it out.
If they screw up, then they're like, well, we told you it was hard.
Oh,
it was
a hard
thing.
Makes sense.
Yeah.
I should use that in my life.
That counts as like major surgery. You're going to get some badass pills for that.
Well... Yeah.
When you get, have you gotten your wisdom teeth out?
No, and that's another thing. He's like, you gotta get this bottom one out,
dude. mine were comedic cutting in. I like didn't. We moved out here. I didn't take care of them. Mm-hmm. They were like all four were cutting.
Okay.
And it was like, all right, let's do it.
Okay.
And I didn't go under for it. And the dentist literally had my head in like a fucking like
what?
Like a chokehold.
Did you feel it?
Well, you feel them. You feel the pressure. Like you feel them pulling.
But it was fine.
Well, I mean, yeah.
Because I was actually fine. Well, he gave me 3 needles of anesthesia.
Yeah.
Because they know how.
Oh yeah, we saw those.
I am.
Check out at Nick Snell on Twitter, and you can see all her anesthesia videos.
Well,
you looked like.
I was
like,
out
I don't think
it.
We should have her on after that.
It lasted for like 5 hours. I tried to eat at one point.
Wait, did you? You went unconscious for?
No. They just gave me 3 needles because they knew that I was like a lunatic.
Gotcha.
Well, the first time I went in there for the cleaning, I told him, I don't want to be here.
Are you a crier?
And
in
I
there?
Told him, I'm 2 seconds to walking out that door. And he said, you haven't smiled since you got here, I said, and I'm not gonna. He was a little worried, so I think they were really worried for this procedure, the fillings
your
procedure.
Your car buying temperament is the same as your dentist.
Oh, yeah. I walked onto the dealership lot, and I was like, please don't let anyone walk up. And a guy walked up. He's like, can I help you? I'm like, I'm looking by myself. He's like, well, maybe there's some cars. I'm like, I don't think so. I've got my eye on a certain thing, and he's just like, let me freaking show you. And then the first thing he showed me, I was like, I love it.
I love it. I'll buy it.
Yeah.
APR, what's that?
And then I walked in there, and I was like, you get this scratch fixed. You said it would be done by Saturday. Get your manager.
That's how you got to be at the dentist. Like, hey, get your manager, doctor.
Well, I did give the secretary a hard time.
I think they're receptionists now.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that person.
They're called receptionists.
Yeah.
You got to be nice to the dentist.
They're Russian or Swedish or something.
My dentist, when I got my wisdom teeth pulled, it was in Van Nuys. It's kind of junky, kind of janky.
Yeah.
And like they didn't put me under. I heard everybody goes under for their wisdom teeth pull, but I didn't go under. And like, oh, it took like weeks to like feel better.
Oh no, my brother
his
just got
gets
his
in
done.
There and it's all fucked up.
Oh, gross.
Yeah.
Well, he said I could actually wait a little bit. He's more of like an LA. Dentist, where the first thing he's worried about is this damn fang tooth because it's cosmetically unattractive. And I'm like, well, actually, I'm worried about this bottom tooth because it's really out of place. He's like,
you
that's the least
it.
Of your worries. I'm like, what?
I think you should keep the fang tooth.
Well, that's what my mother says, but
look at
honestly,
Will
it's really
teeth.
Aggravating. Well, he said it could cause a problem with my lip, that it could change my lip shape.
But, I mean,
I
you've gotten
know. He's
this far.
Very adamant about me getting this tooth pulled
yeah,
out.
Because he wants your money. Of course he's going to be like, yeah, you should get that out.
But I have health insurance.
Yeah. You got good health insurance?
Yeah, from Cheesecake Factory. But I had never used it for 7 years until this month.
Damn.
Yeah.
Dude,
I was like, you know what? I'm going to grow up. I'm not going to be a baby. I was a baby. They had to strap me down when they took my blood at the...
They strapped you down?
Yes, I can't handle it.
Oh, my God.
It's all right. I didn't cry.
That's good. Well, I mean, it's okay to cry. You could cry.
I don't like needles.
No, needles... you know what? Needles did not bother me, like getting shots and stuff. Doesn't bother me.
Just talking about it, I could faint. But you have a paramedic here, right?
Yeah. Yeah. They're here. There's like 3. Here.
Wow, 3.
Right, yeah. We always
that leads me to believe things have gone wrong before.
We always keep 3 on site.
Okay.
All right, you crazy kids. I want to tell you about a company called JC Room Blocks. If you have 10 or more out-of-town guests coming to an event near you, you have a wedding, you have a barbecue, you have a bat mitzvah, a family gathering of sorts, a bris, whatever. You call JC Room Blocks. They do weddings, family reunions, bachelorette parties, bachelor parties, corporate events, holiday parties. They research hotels in your for your wedding in venues, and they find you the best deals. The best deals. Since they're certified travel agents, they can get you the lowest possible rates. On top of discounted rates, they can also negotiate highly discounted bridal suites, shuttle service, and food and beverage functions. If you go to jcroomblocks.com and you mention the Dan and Cody podcast, they'll waive their fee, which makes their service to you completely free. Free consultation, man. They're on Facebook too, and Twitter and Instagram, jcroomblocks.com. I'm telling you, man, they will hook you up. Nobody wants to deal with hotels when they're booking for their events. jcroomblocks.com.
I've been going to the gym a lot.
That's good.
I've lost probably like about 10 pounds, but you can't really, like, honestly, like, you probably couldn't tell. Well, maybe you could.
I could tell.
But, like, because I am smaller anyway, it's just like, I don't know, trying to get past this hump of 130. So I was 140.
Mm-hmm.
Like, and when I get to my worst, it's 140. But then I got down to 130, and that's where I am right now. And I just,
you can't.
It's so hard to get past 130.
Just don't get too skinny. Don't be with those
no,
girls.
No, I want to be a stick.
Don't
Dan.
Do it.
I don't even want my tits anymore.
Don't do it.
They just the make stick, me look bigger.
Dude, the stick girls, it's like, I know it looks better on camera.
Yes, and that's the thing. It really does. Like,
but like, it's just like...
But I'm not being unhealthy about it.
I feel bad for them. Like, I want to like put food on their like table.
I honestly...
Or like walk up to them and be like, are you
I mean, the only time I can get past that 130 is if I don't eat.
Yeah.
And that's... aggravating. So
just eat right and gym it. Are you gymming it? You do a lot of physical
a lot.
Activity.
Yeah. Yeah.
You're bowling, you're kickballing. Yeah.
Well, bowling is going to the next level. I'm getting a coach. Well, I have a coach that I'm meeting with on October 7th.
So you're like serious bowling.
This is going to push me to that next level of
Are you trying
is
to
Is it
like,
possible to be pro?
For
it's,
real?
It's going to be answering the question. If he can't help me, then there's no idea. There's no way. But if he can help me, it's happening. And it could put me out of acting for a little bit. That's how serious this is.
If you go pro bowler, I will come to like all your shit.
I mean,
I swear to God.
You say that, but they're really boring.
Dude, I
like,
will
to
go.
Watch.
I mean,
but honestly, how unique is that?
It's pretty unique.
And you have to be so quiet before they throw the ball, but as soon as you throw the ball, you can be like, oh, you're a whore!
You just sneak them in there. Yeah. Hey, fuck you!
Yeah.
And, but, like, bowling's great because, you know, there's a lot of downtime, and you're in a bowling alley, so, like, you could go to the arcade if you wanted to, and they have, like...
Well, you. You're talking about you as a...
As a watcher, yeah. I'm thinking about other shit I can do yeah. while I'm watching
what
you bowl.
What if I just went into the arcade? Like, oh, yeah. I'll come back when it's my turn.
Just give me a frame here. Right, give me a frame. Yeah. I got to play some Pac-Man.
Right.
But, and like, bowling alleys have good drinks
oh
prices.
My gosh. I bowl at Pins, and it is the hottest place. Like, they were filming a reality show at my league tonight.
Really?
Yeah. They
That's
weren't
cool.
filming us, but they were a couple lanes down filming a reality show. I don't know what show it was, but they film there all the time. Celebrities have their birthdays there almost every night.
Really?
Yeah, there's always celebrities in there.
Dude, I think the last time...
It's so chill, but it's still cool, and...
I
know
bowl.
All the workers there. I know the bartender there. Cherry's Deli is connected to it. That is the bar. Like, it's
That's
a great
awesome.
Spot.
Pins. Where is this?
It's on Ventura in Studio City.
Dude, I want to go bowling.
It's a great place for anyone to go.
Can we go bowling? We'll bring the baby.
It's a commercial.
We'll bring the baby.
You can throw babies down there? No, I'm just kidding.
We'll go bowling. We'll get some White Russians. We'll do the whole Big Lebowski
oh my gosh,
thing.
White Russians? That sounds good. But I'm vegan, so I can't have that.
Oh, right. Seasonally vegan.
I could just have a million White Russians. Well,
dude,
I'd be sick, but they're so easy to drink.
That's the only alcoholic drink that I can handle with milk.
Oh, well,
like,
yeah.
I really don't like any kind of...
I do like mudslides, though, and
any kind of, like, shake with liquor in it or, like, a slushy with liquor in it,
yeah.
It's like, it fucking...
Well, makes me sick. It's very sweet.
But I can do a White Russian. Even coffee with Bailey's, I hate
Don't
it.
You?
But I like regular coffee.
Yeah. I love Irish coffees. It's tequila and coffee, but they don't put the cream in there. Well, it's they put Kahlua in, but they don't put anything cream in there. I love those, and they will cure any cold.
Coffee, tequila, and what?
All my friends know that if I feel like I'm getting sick, that I go to El Compadre and I have 10
I love El Compadre.
Mexican coffees, and it's just tequila, Kahlua, and coffee.
10?
But it's so hot, and it burns your throat, and I'm cured.
And then you're done.
Well, I'm wasted, but I'm cured for... Oh, wait, maybe I'm just cured for that night.
Yeah,
I'm drunk and I don't realize it. No, that's like my thing, because I don't take medicine.
You just won't do it?
I don't like medicine.
You're against it?
It's a Willig thing.
You know it helps, right? Like, it's proven.
Helps stuff? Yeah.
It does help things.
I just don't like putting things into...
I do a lot of DayQuil.
Do you?
But
like,
I don't
when
get
you're not sick?
No.
Because that's not good.
No. When I'm sick. But I don't get sick often. I think... I don't get sick often because I'm a nail biter.
What does that mean?
You pick up all the... You like, introduce your system to a ton of germs because you're sick. I mean, because you have shit on your hands.
Oh, okay. So like, I should just eat shit next time I think I'm going to be sick. Yeah. Actually, I should just eat shit all the time.
Just eat...
I'll never get sick.
Just lick your fingers a lot throughout the day.
Ew.
You build it
so
up.
So disgusting.
You build it up.
Imagine bowling and, like, licking your...
Ooh. Yeah, it's gross.
Anyway, so I could be pro the next time I'm on this podcast. Oh my god.
That would be crazy, so dude. I want to go. I want to see you play for
dude,
real.
Dude, like this guy,
he runs
California bowling.
Really?
Like he is an ex-pro. Maybe still pro. I don't know. He's kind of older, but his name is Mark Baker, and he charges $100 an hour.
A hundy an hour?
Mm-hmm. That's all crazy.
You have to pay him for
it
to come coach you?
I have to go 2 hours out. I'm going farther than I came here.
You have to go to him to pay him
He's
to
that
teach
good.
You how to bowl.
He's that good, Dan. This is a big time thing. This was a life-changing decision that I made. And
I was all about this, and now it sounds scammy.
No.
It sounds
no,
like a scam.
Trust me. I know.
He can bowl?
I know this stuff. I know about bowling.
You want to take one of our paramedics with you to make sure that it's all good?
That
it's,
he doesn't
legit.
Kill me.
Yeah. He takes
Trust
your
me.
100.
He has a camp that's like $4,000 with Chris Barnes, who's a professional bowler.
Do you have a bowling shirt?
I couldn't do that camp. I would love to do that, but I do have a bowling shirt for my old team. It's very tight, and my tits stick out, so I don't like that. My teammate made them so that the girls were wearing tight shirts where their tits stick out.
What? But that's like anti-traditional bowling shirt.
Right.
Like
I would love, and like, I've been trying to get my teams plural. I have a million teams now, to get nice, real bowling shirts. But I might buy one myself that's like a Ebonite approved apparel, because now they're not using the retro shirts anymore.
I want one of those retro
they're
shirts.
Using the light, like dry fit, very very light, because you have there's so much movement like that's in
like Under Armour
close to your body that you can't have anything like I mean I'm wearing a t-shirt now and like yoga pants, which is what I prefer to bowl in because it's so
freeing.
Yeah you have to. I mean, I think professional bowlers, women, wear skorts.
What?
Shorts underneath of skirts.
Culottes?
What's that?
I don't know. My mom used to always say it. My mom used to wear shorts and call them split skirts. And be like, Mom, those are just shorts. She's like, it's a split skirt.
Well,
like, what are you talking
there
about?
There might be a split skirt because I have a split. I think she's...
What is a split
skirt? I have
skirt?
An old vintage skirt that is shorts, but it looks like a skirt, but it's shorts. So she might be right.
Maybe she is right.
No, seriously.
My mom usually is
it's
right.
It's very, very vintage where I got it.
Hmm.
For a play or something.
So now all the bowlers are wearing these, like...
I think women...
Under Armour shit?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah,
that
exactly.
That material?
I mean, it's modern day now. We're not in Kingpin, the movie. We're in...
God, I love
the retro
Kingpin.
Stuff.
This day in history. Thursday, September 29th, 2016. Kittens filmed the Kitten Bowl. The furry, fleet-footed pawflets of Kitten Bowl 4 didn't exactly have the plays down Wednesday at the taping of the annual Cuteness Fest that airs on Hallmark Channel each Super Bowl Sunday. Chaos ensued, but it was all good as cameras rolled on a Midtown soundstage with Beth Stern deftly juggling a few frisky critters during interviews promoting the event. This day in history.
So I have been filming a lot lately.
You've been shooting.
And I think it's due to Nerdist and UCB on my resume. Because I've been booking a lot of sketch-based stuff.
Yeah.
And they're mainly webisodes.
That's awesome.
There's a lot happening.
Through Hooch?
No. Through just them booking me.
Oh, really?
Just because I have all that training on my resume.
Right.
I feel like there's a small group of people that are doing those things, and I'm in it, I think. I don't know. Because this month I've filmed so much. Like, I was so grateful. But a lot of companies are starting their own channel now. Like, YouTube, started their own, like, Netflix.
Like YouTube Red?
Yes.
What the fuck is that?
And I just filmed a show for that.
What is it?
At the YouTube space in Culver Cities, and that space is so sick, dude.
You've been there, right? You've been in there.
It's so sick.
I heard, yeah, like, if you're, like, a verified YouTuber or something.
And then you
like,
can film there for free.
You can film whatever the fuck you want.
Yep.
That's
it's
ridiculous.
So cool. They have a cafe inside of there that any guest that comes in can get any like thing they want, like coffees and specialty coffees and stuff. And then they have like various photo booths set up.
Really?
Yeah. You can just walk around the space and take pictures.
I'm imagining like a Google looking place.
Yes, it is like that.
Like it's all like yeah. There's a slide in there and
yeah.
shit. And like...
Yes, they have a pole, a fireman's pole.
God
I didn't
damn
go
it.
Down there.
It's so cool.
But you,
how do we get there, Nicole?
You can rent out the space. I don't know how much it is. Or you can have a number of followers on YouTube. I forget what the number is to where you're allowed to use it for free. So I was there for a YouTube show. It was a mock game show with, a very popular YouTube celebrity. And I can't even remember her name now. It's like this obnoxious black woman that wears like glitter all over her lips and she like sticks her lips out and like that's her look. She's being raunchy. She's not being
I don't know all the
cute.
I don't know many of the YouTube stars.
I know Viners.
I know Jenna Marbles. That's the only YouTube star.
Yeah. I've heard of her.
Yeah.
But she was the host and it was like I can't give all the details of it because it does have a twist to it. But it was fun because I'm used to being on game shows, and it was all improv.
So you can't watch it unless you pay for YouTube Red?
I don't know.
Or...
I guess. Huh. It's not out yet. I also did a sketch-based show, which was a mock game show, called Give Me My Phone Back, or it was I Want My Phone Back. Maybe it was I Want My Phone Back, but I'm SAG, so everyone that casts me, they're casting me as union, but they had me as an actor on the show, but they were also doing it as a real game show where the host takes your phone and can go into it and they hook up all the production people to your phone.
Fuck that.
And they have full access to every single thing on there. They can actually manipulate and type on the phone through a computer or something.
What?
And
they just have access to everything.
And they have levels of money that you can win based off what you allow the host to do with your phone. It
really?
Was much harder than I expected.
So what? They're like, can I send
I can't
a
give
dick
away
pic from your
too
phone?
Many details, but let's just say,
like, we found your nudes. Can we send one to Dad?
I didn't
shit like that.
Show up there with nudes on my phone. Thank you, Dan. What, Dan?
I don't
why
know.
Why would I do that?
I thought all girls have nudes on their phone.
I did, but I took them off there before I got on the show.
Oh, that's smart.
Good.
That's smart. Hey, well then, why doesn't everyone just go on this show and wipe their phone first?
She says, well, because I was a paid actor on there.
Oh, okay.
Everyone else, they were stopping on the street, and they didn't get very far because maybe I'm saying too much.
Say it.
I'm like, maybe, where's my confidentiality form?
Dude, those forms are fucking crazy.
Yeah.
Like, for especially for game shows.
I was on a something.
They like you.
And I was supposed to be quiet about a certain thing, and they immediately...
They hit you up?
Called me and said, get that off your Instagram right now.
Are you serious?
Yeah, that was weird.
Dude, if you've ever seen one of these game show contracts people, they, like, it is in there. There's
you
all kinds of crazy
anything.
Wordage.
And that was years after. And
yeah.
I was like,
and they're like,
hey,
we can sue
check
you.
Me out. I'm playing this, blah, blah, blah. And they're like, get that. They called me immediately as soon as I posted it. So they are
always watching
you. So anyway, the details about the show that I was on.
That was all made up.
Hold on. I got a phone call.
Yeah.
I heard a text. Let's just say the first thing they wanted to do, I already was like, are you kidding me? They just wanted to post something absurdly rude on a random person's page, like post on my phone. Like, they just took Facebook, scrolled their finger down and said, whatever it lands on, we're putting a post that's rude on their current status. They pulled up this girl that I do not... I don't even know if I know her.
Uh-huh.
She's just in, like, the UCB Upright Citizens Brigade improv sketch world.
Right.
And so we usually add each other. Like, everybody adds each other to use people, to use props and stuff.
Sure, sure.
And they wrote something so rude to her life-changing post. And I was like, oh, my God, this is for $5? I was like, you know what?
Like,
do it. Anyway, so that was for Comcast's new thing, and they partnered up with College Humor for that show. So Comcast is starting their own thing, too. I think it was Comcast, somebody. It's the same thing. Everyone's starting their own Netflix thing. I just found out recently that Amazon and Netflix are paying their actors, their celebrity actors, more money than movie and TV.
Yeah.
And that's how they're getting all the actors. And they're actually willing to pay those A-list actors more money and take fewer, like, background people and, like, you know, like...
Extras and...
Well, day players. Like, they are willing to cut... Though I heard this from a casting director. It's like, they're cutting the day players just so they can pay those big names to be on the shows. That's what Netflix is paying the most, and Amazon's trying to compete with them now.
Yeah.
Everything's going to be webisode or, you know, you don't even have cable anymore, right?
No, yeah, we're done.
Yeah.
And we watch more now than we did when we had cable.
I mean...
And we just do Hulu, Netflix, and Amazon. Those are only paid... subscriptions.
I filmed something else for my God, I can't even remember. It's another comedy-based website.
Mm-hmm.
Above Average is what it's called. AboveAverage.com. It's another, like, Funny or Die website.
Okay.
And they're putting out their web series, and I worked 2 days on that.
That's cool.
And so... everyone's doing that. That's all I've been booking, which is amazing. And that's SAG AFTRA is what I've been, you know, it's...
And that's what it is. You don't necessarily have, like, the idea of TV, of being on TV, is so different from what it was
when
we were even in college.
I still want it.
To what it is now.
I still do want it, though.
Like, you...
I still do.
Yeah.
When I was at YouTube, I called Bianca and I was, well, I didn't call her, I text her. I text Bianca and I was like, we need to start a YouTube show now.
Mm-hmm.
I was like, because we could definitely. And she's hot up. As hell.
Stuff gets picked up.
And she's
up
funny.
Like that.
And our rapport back and forth is great. Mm-hmm. She's on my Hooch, my sketch team.
Okay.
And we're the only girls on there, but we are like best friends. And
well, don't forget about your boys, Dan and Cody. Over
no,
here.
I know.
We'll get on some web shit.
No,
with
I know.
You.
That's what I'm saying. Let's is like this. If we start our own show, and to be honest, I wouldn't mind doing driving with Nicole because it's pretty intense.
You should do driving with your grass character.
With
Yeah. All right. So for
So Jay. I keep saying a different name, but her name's Jay.
Mm.
She's androgynous, I guess.
There. If you check out Nicole's YouTube, it's on your YouTube, right?
Well, it's on. It's actually on Nerdist Schools.
Oh,
it's
right.
It's not on YouTube.
Nerdist.
Because they make us go through them.
Go to Nerdist School and watch Nicole's video where she plays this like uptight.
Nerdist School on YouTube. Their channel. You can see it. It's called Jay. And she's against weed grass smoking.
Yeah, she just runs around calling it grass. She's like
picking up people and putting them in the car and making sure they get home safe.
You're like on the verge of making citizens' arrests. Like you're just patrolling the streets trying to get people to not
but
drive
only
on
people
grass.
That have smoked. Yeah,
the shit is like she's probably on grass. They're on grass.
And I have a sword in my car for a weapon. Now, it's funny because that sketch, we wanted to film something, my sketch team, Hooch.
Mm-hmm.
And we had the weekend, you know, to film something because we try to put out at least one sketch a month.
Right.
And we didn't have any real sketches that we wanted to put up yet or that were ready. So Riley wrote that sketch like the night before and said,
really?
Nicole, play this character. I hadn't even read the script yet. We just all showed up. We knew we were going to film this in a car. We had the equipment. And
it's a really good character for you.
It was a little hard for me to get into it.
Yeah.
Because I have to be so, like.
You're deadpan.
Yes.
Yeah. And that's not something you do
like,
all the time.
It's like a character from The Office or something. You know, like how they're just so
dry.
Yeah,
it's not something that
and
I've
once,
seen you
once
do.
He got me to the point that he wanted, Riley, who wrote it, and he was directing it, then I was fine with doing the rest of the... I mean, it is a good character for me because it's kind of similar to me, just with less energy, I guess.
Well, because your other characters are very bubbly, like Baby Deer.
Well, did you ever see... Baby Deer.
Deer Baby.
Did you ever see Sal?
Who's Sal?
Yeah. Sal is... my best character, and I want to write it into another sketch. Sal is she got fired. Another kind of like androgynous character.
Mm-hmm.
She got fired from being a park ranger because she didn't win the park ranger award, and Susan got it. So she beat up Susan, and so she got fired as a park ranger. So then she got a new job as a librarian, but all she can tell the kids is about this story
like
about
Ranger
Susan
shit.
And her phrase is, who gives a shit? That's pretty much said after everything she says. She's like, well, Susan won the award, but who gives a shit? It's, Dan, it's crazy.
Have you
like,
shot
it's
anything
an
with
SNL
her?
Character. It's like the outfit and everything. It's like a boy. I have like a Boy Scout, like Park Ranger outfit. The wig is ridiculous. It's a really tight, like brown curled wig. It's worse than that. I have the big glasses on that I wear at the Oscars that like make my eyes huge and I can barely see when I wear them, but I love it because it puts me into character.
Right.
But it's a great character and I need to put it back into another sketch. But everyone loves Sal.
I love Sal.
Yeah. Who gives a shit? But I always like throw my body around with that. It's great. I love it.
It's awesome.
I love
dude.
Playing characters like that, you know?
It's fun, man. It's fun. Like the coolest thing about acting and is that you get to not be you for a little bit.
Yeah.
That's always like the
it's
best
so
part.
It's so crazy. I've actually been really good like lately in my life.
Yeah.
Like I've been more positive.
That's good.
And I honestly can thank yoga for that, which I never thought I'd say that.
Yoga.
I hated it forever, but then I did heated yoga, and I was like, oh, okay, okay, all right. Okay,
yeah, I get
sweating
it.
Like a lot.
Yeah, is
it's
it
worth it?
Is it
but,
worth it?
But the way that you work hard and then at the end of it, it's hot as fuck, Dan.
Yeah,
it's
why?
It's like 119 degrees, and you're working out with weights and kettlebells.
And
this
it's
ain't,
yoga.
They say, well, yes, it's combined. Some of the classes are combined. When you're doing just straight yoga, it's still freaking hard. It's hot as hell.
Yeah, I was doing like the P90X yoga. When I did P90X.
Okay. That shit was it's probably hard. The similar stuff, but imagine doing that in 115 degrees.
That can't be healthy.
It's well, it is. It's great. It's like wringing your body out. Like, honestly, most of the moves, they, like when you wring a rag, it's wringing out the bad out of your body.
Getting out that juju.
But the some of the teachers, when you have good ones, instructors, they inspire you with things and it's like you had just worked really hard, so you're more able to accept what they're saying and internalize it and
right.
leave there with a better attitude. And honestly, Dan, it's crazy. Like, the dentist said recently, he's like, oh my God, you're smiling today. And I wanted to say, shut the fuck up. I'm happy. Fuck. Damn it. Shit. But, like, seriously, I have been happy. Like, one of the instructors said, the only thing you have to ask yourself every morning when you wake up is, do I want to be happy or don't I want to be happy today?
Well,
and I've been trying to live like that.
I think, like, yeah, that, of course, like, you wake up.
There's other questions, but that's, like, the main. Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, and when you do make that choice early on, it honestly, Dan, I've had so much luck. I never have luck.
Yeah.
I've come into money that I didn't expect. Like, it's crazy.
Well, and is that because of the yoga or because you're saying I'm going to be happy?
It's because I'm putting it into the universe, I think.
Yeah, I mean.
Because everything that's happened to me lately has been really great.
Yeah.
And it's because I'm treating other people better, which I needed to do that.
That's good.
And
you're a nicer person.
I'm giving more. I mean, I donated about $5,000 worth of, not 5,000, that's ridiculous. I donated my apartment today. No, I donated $500 worth of stuff to Goodwill and to the council, thrift council today alone.
We'll take all that stuff.
You don't want that stuff.
Don't donate. I heard Goodwill's bullshit now.
That's why I went to thrift council, but they will only take really good stuff.
The Goodwill's all for profit now.
Well,
right?
It doesn't really matter. It's good for taxes. But I'm helping people.
you're helping Goodwill
people.
Sell shit to
it
other people.
Who gives a shit? You know.
Sorry, I'm not trying to be the
but the guy at
here.
Goodwill today, he was racist towards me, and I'm really upset about it.
What do you do?
And I'm going to tell them about it.
What do you do?
Well, this lunatic that I remember last time I went to Goodwill, his name is Willie. And if you're out there listening, I'm coming after you, bud. that would be what Sal would say to Susan. His name's Willie,
uh-huh.
And he's black. I'm only saying that because he was racist towards me, and I do not like that. And
nobody does.
No, Dan, it was so rude. I walked in, and every time I go in there, he chucks everything that I bring in into these bins. I had a very good working printer in there and a projector.
You donated a printer?
Yeah.
We'll take that
printer. 'Cause I have a new one, but it's an older model.
Okay.
But anyway, he's chucking it into a bin and throwing everything into this bin, like throwing it over his head for no reason. Did he need to do that?
He threw a printer over his head?
Yes! And he's just like, yeah, have you ever been here before? And I'm like, yeah, I had you. He's like, ah, okay, well, is that your bag? I'm just like, no, these are my four bags. Okay, well, this, when you come in here, you put the clothes in here. This is wasting my time. Put the clothes in here. I'm like,
come on, Willie.
Chill, bud. I'm donating and I'm doing a good thing for people.
You
don't treat
him,
me like shit. No,
you told
I didn't say
chill,
that.
Bud.
I didn't. I just was quiet because I was like, I remember this guy. And then he throws the printer into this bin and I'm like, hey, there's electronics in there. And he was like, oh, sorry. And then he, like, didn't give a shit.
He didn't realize it was electronics.
And then I was like, can
it?
I have that IKEA bag? And he's like, well, next time you should. And I go, well, next time I'm going to bring the same damn bag and you're going to give it to me because it's heavy.
Yeah.
Sheepers creep. Because I had one of those big, like, tarp, like IKEA bags that can hold a lot of stuff that has a strap on it, so I can bring all that stuff.
Right.
Threw the bag in there. I was like, can I just want that bag back because I need to be able to carry. He goes, well, next time. I was like, yeah, next time I'm going to bring this bag again.
Yeah.
I actually said that to him. And he's like, oh, good. Well, you know what? Hey, do you need a receipt? I'm like, yeah, what the fuck do you think I'm here for?
Yeah, what you think this
Goodwill?
Is?
Goodwill? No, I'm here for tax break, you fucker. So he fills out this paper and he's going, oh, well, now I want you to go home and drink Kool-Aid. And I'm like, no, I'm not doing. I literally told him, I'm not doing that.
Who drinks
He's like,
Kool-Aid anymore?
This guy's a lunatic, okay? I remember it from last time. I got into a fight with him last time, too. So he was like, I want you to go home, drink Kool-Aid, and I want you to watch the debates, and I want you to come back here and tell me that your boy isn't going to be president. And I go, what do you mean, my boy?
Your boy.
And he was like, you know, your boy. And I was like, so are you being racist right now? I literally said that to him because I was just like done with this guy.
Yeah.
And that is very racist, first of all.
Like, why is he your
boy? And I was
boy?
Like, you know what? Maybe I do like Trump. I don't want to tell too much about the story, but like,
maybe,
I don't want people
maybe
like,
I do
me.
Like Kool-Aid, asshole.
No, he was like, I was like, excuse me, so you're saying that I like Trump because I'm white? And he was like, well, you know, I would say that to anybody. And I was like, just give me the receipt. And I took the receipt, and he was like, yeah, bye. And I was like, fuck you.
Fuck you, Willie.
Yeah.
Not everybody likes
Trump.
I am
really mad about that. That is fucked up.
Well, yeah, I mean, you can't.
No, he was being racist towards me, and that's not fair.
Yeah, he was. Yeah, he put he made a judgment.
It goes always.
He passed
racism
judgment
goes to everybody,
him.
And I was pissed off about that because that's really fucked up.
Yeah.
And I was only there to drop off some shit. Like,
well,
why did I get offended within the 5 minutes? I don't even think I was there for 5 minutes.
Well, you probably left your pro-Trump propaganda in your printer, and he just assumed that you were your pro-Trump, your boy. And you had your
right,
pin,
my boy.
You had your pin on that said,
oh,
Trump's
well,
my boy.
Yeah. I did go in dressed as Trump, no.
Trump's my boy.
Yeah.
I love that, your boy.
He's a piece of shit. That's the second time I've been pissed off at him for saying something rude to me when I'm literally just going in there. It's supposed to take a second.
Yeah.
He's always throwing the shit into the bins. I'm like,
come on, Willie. Get it together.
I'm like, I'm going to go back to Thrift Council. Do you know what that is?
Thrift Council? No.
Can't even say it.
Is that
Thrift Council. It's a Jewish...
Is that where all the other thrift stores like meet up to like decide... Who's going to be the best
Jewish
thrift store?
Thrift store, and they only accept clean, non-stained items.
Oh.
So
like,
I'm going back there.
So it's like high-class thrift?
Yeah. Well, you get more off your taxes if you go there.
Really?
Yeah. I get a lot back in taxes because I'm...
What makes them specifically a Jewish thrift?
They say that.
Really?
Yes.
They're just
mm-hmm.
like, we're the Jewish thrift.
Yes. Yeah.
Huh.
Live, marry, kill.
Since you're into sketch comedy,
okay. Phew.
We're gonna do some Saturday Night Live All Stars for you. So, and I know you love Amy Poehler, so Amy Poehler's in there. Amy Poehler, Will Ferrell, and Chris Farley. Kill, marry. Who's it going to be?
I'd kill Chris Farley.
Me too.
Yeah.
I don't really like
pointless.
Chris Farley that much. So you're marrying Will
great.
Or marrying Amy or fucking Will or fucking Amy.
That's tough.
It's hard.
Because
what's turning?
I'd do both with both of them, so that's the problem.
You think Will Ferrell's attractive?
I love him to death.
He's funny.
I love him.
Funny and funny helps.
I do
helps.
Not find him super attractive, but I
humor
oh my God.
It
yes.
adds a level of attractiveness.
Yeah, it's yeah, it adds a lot actually.
Yeah, if you can make somebody laugh, they'll want to take their pants off.
But the thing is, I feel like Will wouldn't be a good husband.
No?
Mm-mm.
Why?
I feel like you'd have a temper. He always has a temper in his movies.
God damn it!
And you know that movie is real life.
Yeah.
I think Amy and I would have a great future.
Yeah, you and Amy.
I feel like we would just be, all right, I'll fuck Will Ferrell and marry Amy.
Fucking Will, marry Amy. Okay.
I like how I always know who to kill first.
Yeah, I would. I
usually
would,
that's the hard thing for people.
I would probably kill Chris Farley. I'd probably marry Will, because we'd just be like two peas in a pod, like just giggling and being happy together.
Yeah, exactly. Then, that was my thing with Amy.
And then, of course, I would bang Amy.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
All right.
That's what I would do there.
I would fuck her so hard. That's not part of the game. It's just fuck, marry, kill. I'd bang the shit out of the- Okay.
There is a woman.
I already hate it.
She's auctioning off her virginity online to pay for school.
Okay.
And her reasoning.
Wait, this isn't tied into me somehow, is it?
No. Well, yeah, Matt, because like when you auctioned off your virginity, that no, I'm just kidding. The price of good education.
I bought a gumball.
She's a 20-year-old student. Her name's Ariana. She's auctioning off her virginity on an escort site in order to raise money to study abroad.
How'd you find that?
I heard it on.
You heard.
I heard it on the radio. Mm-hmm. Well, I placed a couple.
You
bids.
Were shopping.
It's like, whose virginity should I buy today? Oh, she looks nice.
So did it happen?
The bidding starts at £130,500.
Damn.
Yeah.
Wait, pounds. That's not...
That's a lot more than...
Oh, it is?
$130,000. Yeah. Went online last week on the Russian-based escort site, Cinderella with an S.
Oh, nice. I like that.
Yeah, and she says, many students have the issue that during their studies, they have to deal with multiple problems. You have to go to work in order to pay for your education, she said in the report. I want to move to another country for my studies in medicine. The university will be very expensive, the rent will also be high, and I imagine that living in another country will be very hard. Therefore, I want to get the financial burden out of the way so I can focus on my medical studies. Is that cool or is that like fucked up? I think it's kind of fucked up. But it is her virginity, you know?
But it is also prostitution.
Yeah.
So that's the bad part about it.
Yeah. So like and then she is using it to like go to school and be a doctor and she's never had sex before. So it's kind of like, well, I mean, your first time's never really that great anyway. Why not, like, make some money and go to school? I can see that side of it.
Yeah.
But then it's like...
I would never do that.
Yeah, I don't think I would do it either.
But then again, we made it through college with help from our parents, I guess.
Yeah.
So I don't know how desperate she is to get out of a certain situation, you know?
Yeah.
You don't know her background, which this could...
She says, why should I wait any longer? Why should I lose my virginity to someone who could then break my heart? She's got a point.
Well, that part's not great. Because
elaborate,
that's a very
please.
Negative way of thinking about that.
So she's just like, I think her mindset is
I should just never
like,
date any guy.
Yeah.
Well, actually, that's kind of my thought process now.
She's like, well, it's going to suck anyway, so why not make some money and pay for school?
Do you think she's actually a virgin?
Wait, what? That's a good point. Like if you then have sex with her, you could be like, nah, this is bullshit. You're
right.
Not a virgin.
Oh my god, you could return the money.
Yeah.
Oh my god, we should tell her that.
False advertising.
Like if he doesn't see blood,
yeah,
he's like refund now.
Yeah. And what
I'm returning this shit.
And what exactly is taking her virginity? Like, is it a full sexual encounter?
Yes, of course.
Or are we talking insertion?
Anal?
Oh. Yes, anal. Like, are we talking just insert and out?
No,
that's
ridiculous.
That would
Who
technically
would pay for that.
I don't know. I'm sure somebody would.
You could do that to a banana peel. for free. Yeah. Well, for what, 75 cents?
I mean, she's not, look at her. She's not that hot or anything.
Oh, she's pretty.
She's pretty, but.
She looks like a whore. I don't.
She doesn't look like a virgin.
Perfect time to
enter. Hey, guys.
Oh, no, she does not look like a virgin.
She doesn't look like a virgin.
Who are you looking at?
This girl is auctioning off her virginity, and the bidding starts at £130,000.
Well, how do you even know if she's a virgin?
Wait, £135,000?
Yeah.
Because that's a lot.
£130,000. I mean, I don't think I could auction off my virginity back then. No one would buy it.
What about your butt?
Auction off my butt.
You still have that, Dan.
How do you know?
Oh my god. I guess I don't.
No, you do. You do know. You know.
Okay.
I wouldn't auction my butt. But yeah, I mean, I'm kind of on the side of more power to her. If she...
What? More like, power to her? I don't think that's so many, the phrase to use.
Like, your first time is not always your best. It's usually not your best. It's
but
usually
wait,
very terrible.
Aren't there a million other things she could do?
I guess. But she's trying to get 130...
How about get a job, you filthy whore? Like the rest of us.
Stop trying to sling it all over town.
Why not have a dad that pays for everything?
Oh my god. But yeah, so there's that. So you're against it completely.
I did not say I was against it completely.
I'm sort of on the fence. Hey, monkey.
I thought that was a dog. Sorry. What was that noise?
It's our baby.
it's our dog baby.
What was that noise? Oh.
Welcome to the podcast, Ma.
She just wants to say hi.
Hey,
Bubba.
Hey.
Wait, what was that? I hear a bid.
Yeah. Moxie wants to have virginity.
Okay, we're going.
Okay.
All right. So
she brings the baby in here 1 minute and I'm already auctioning. No.
No.
Kidding.
No, not Moxie's.
No. I wasn't thinking that.
She's way too young.
That's ridiculous.
But, I mean, school.
Little bush deer. I could auction off little bush deer's
bush.
There you
go. Cody would be interested.
Hooch. Sketch team is the sketch team that I'm on. We have a show on October 8th.
Oh, yeah.
Is it?
October 8th.
October 8th at 8 p.m. at Nerdist School on Sunset and Gardner. And it's the show's theme is friendship, and it's our silliest show. It's our most high energy show. So the sketch that I wrote is about two girls based off a real story in a Jeep Wrangler. In Florida, on the beach. They got to drive their Jeep up onto the beach.
Florida or Florida? Is this a made-up place?
Florida.
Florida?
Am I saying it weird?
No, not at all. Okay. I love Florida.
Okay. It's not Florida.
It's Florida.
When you live in Florida for... Well, I didn't live there, but...
Florida!
People that are locals say Florida.
We live in Florida. Miami, Florida.
Do I say that weird?
I don't.
It wasn't Miami, but Daytona Beach.
I would
anyway,
say
so
Florida.
They drove their Jeep Wrangler up onto the beach, and they're like, "Oh my god, best spring break ever! This Jeep is so sick! I can't believe we're allowed to drive up on the beach."
Mm-hmm.
And then the guys approach them, and they're like, "Hey," or it's like, "Yo, girl, that Jeep's dope." And I'm just like, "Thanks." Her name's Sweet Pea. I'm not gonna do the whole sketch, but
no, do it.
It ends up into. Well, he's like, "Oh, hey, Sweet Pea." And then Melissa's like, "No, my name's Melissa. The Jeep's Sweet Pea." And he's like, "Oh, hi, Melissa. Hi, Sweet Pea." And all these guys start coming out and talking to the Jeep. They're not talking. They're hitting on the Jeep.
I like that.
They're not hitting on the girls. It gets ridiculous. It's only a 4-page sketch, and it's not that long, but it really escalates. So they're putting their dick in the gas tank. They're fucking the car.
I gotta
see
this.
They're fingering the oil change thing under the hood. And then at the end, a motorcycle, he goes, "Hey, go get Roxy. Roxy is a motorcycle. We can have a threesome."
Mm-hmm.
Brings the motorcycle out. I have to create these things, by the way. I have to make a Jeep and a motorcycle. And then he winds up killing the guy while fucking him in the ass with the motorcycle. So that's my sketch based off friendship.
You better talk to Willie at Goodwill and get a Jeep. And
well, it was based off the Jeep that I had, Sweepy, my whole life. Huge Jeep.
Beautiful.
And it really was an ridiculous. It was the biggest Jeep in Maryland.
And you've memorialized.
Like, I made it to be that. Yeah.
You've immortalized it by doing this sketch about people fucking it.
There's a Hitler sketch.
Love Hitler comedy.
It's a Hitler and Joey, a sitcom way back when. It's pretty funny. There's
And can you still drink at these shows?
$5? Yes, you can.
It's not $5 all you can drink?
They won't let us do that anymore.
Somebody threw up.
No. No, you can still drink there. It's BYOB. Okay. You can't advertise alcohol being there.
I see. Gotcha.
Because, I don't know, someone fucked up. but it's a great, it's very funny. There's a guy makes out with a dead body.
It's an intimate setting, too. I really liked it when I went.
Yeah.
It's fun.
But we're sharing the hour now with another sketch team, and they're great as well.
Money Pit.
Yes, you're right. Mm-hmm. And so it's just a lot of comedy happening, but that's it's still awesome. In 1 hour.
When I saw you guys perform, who was the guy who had to eat all that shit and still talk?
Nick. And always writes sketches where he's eating.
I thought he was going
to die.
Because
he loves to do that.
Dude, he had
and
so much food in his mouth.
The school doesn't like us doing it anymore because it's messy.
It's very messy.
We usually pick sketches that are very messy, and they're like, you can't.
Me and Marshall were sitting up close for that one, and we were like, he's going to spit food
that
on us.
That is one of the best sketches we've ever had.
The squirrel. He eats like a squirrel.
Well, he was raised by squirrels. And
what's his name?
In a business meeting. Nick is the actor's name.
What's up, Nick? I hope you listen to this. That sketch is fucking funny as shit.
Yeah, we did it. We were paid to do it at UCLA.
Really?
Yeah.
You're paid to do that sketch?
Yes.
No way.
They invited us as a guest for one of their shows to perform that sketch.
Did they pay you to do Grease?
No, but guess what?
Summer Nights?
We are in production for that.
Oh, yeah?
So I wrote
a
sketch
music video?
That's a Grease parody about dick pics, and our coach of our team, Greg, he's actually gonna direct it.
That'd be cool.
Yeah, it's gonna be pretty. Like we're gonna probably pay someone to DP. Like it's just gonna be a bigger production than everything, and we gotta record all the music and everything.
Yeah. That's cool.
So that's happening soon. Which is going to be so great.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Well, I'm excited for you, Nicole. You're going to be a pro bowler. You're going to fix all your teeth. You got a new car. You're doing
hot yoga.
Yeah,
there's a lot of things happening.
You're a happy person. You're in a good spot. Dude.
Yeah. It's good.
Fuck yeah. Oh.
Should we say bye?
Yeah. Thanks for listening.
Bye.
Goodbye, everybody.
Come out to the Hooch Sketch Show.
Yeah, come to the Hooch Sketch Show. What's your handles? How can people...
Hashtag Hooch Comedy. Hashtag Hooch Sketch Comedy. Hashtag Hooch Sketch.
And then at Nerdist School is the Instagram and Twitter, I believe.
Oh, I was giving hashtags.
What's your Twitter?
Nick Snell.
@NixNell. At Nick Snell. At Nerdist School.
Go onto my IMD page, Nicole Ann Nelson.
Go on that page, click it, love it, like it, and Vine.
Make love to it.
Make love to it. There's a lot of cool pictures on there.
Oh, God.
Hey, everybody, play the tough guy to shoot. All right.